Oxford Dictionary's definition of success is the accomplishment of an aim or purpose.
That's life. That's what people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change their tune when I'm back on top, back on top in June. Stomping on a dream, but I just can't let it get me down. Oh no, 'cause that big old world keeps spinning around. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn, and a queen. Each time I find myself flat on my face, I pick myself up and get back in the race. That's life. Oh, I can't deny it. I thought I quit it, but my friends just wouldn't buy it. But if I thought it wasn't worth a try, I'd hop right on that big bird and I'd fly. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn, and a queen. I've been up and down and over and out. Oh, the drama I've seen. Each time I find myself flat on my face, I pick myself up. Just thank God for the present, that's life.
Hi, everyone. How y'all doing tonight? Oof, some of you got really mad at that one. Oh, I feel so blessed to have so many people I love in one room. My goal here tonight is to make you think, make you feel, make you laugh, maybe make you cry, and make you see. I've been lately thinking about my lifetime, all the things I've done and how it's been. I want you to think about something. What is success? Is it making all the dollars? Is it obtaining a certain social status? Is it getting the big promotion? Or is it bigger than these things?
It now, it's been a good life all in all. It's really fine to have the chance to hang around, lie there by the fire and watch the evening tide, while all my friends and my old lady sit and pass the pipe around and talk of poems and prayers and promises, things that we believe in. How sweet it is to love someone, how right it is to care, how long it's been since yesterday. What about tomorrow? What about our dreams and all the memories we share?
The days, they pass so quickly now. The nights are seldom long. The time around me whispers when it's cold. The changes somehow frighten me. Still, I have to smile. It turns me on to think of growing old. And though my life's been good to me, there's still so much to do. So many things my mind has never known. I'd like to raise a family. I'd like to sail away and dance across the mountains of the moon. That song was from my first professional show out in Grand Lake, Colorado, which is now my favorite place in the world. Where are my Grand Lake people? Oh yeah, they actually got engaged and married in Grand Lake. The show was called Almost Heaven, which was a John Denver musical, which Jim was actually in with me over there. I had just come out of the worst time of my life and felt as though I could never be myself again. I went through a horrible breakup with my college boyfriend where we had to do a show together and sing together. That was really fun. I was in a car accident where it was a miracle I even survived and was dealing with some very heavy physical pain. And my best friend in the world, my grandmother, my mama, died a painful death from cancer where I watched her scream in agony until her final moments. All in 1 month. I was broken, but Colorado helped to heal me and started the path for so many new adventures I never thought I'd experience in this lifetime. Like performing on a cruise ship, for example. That was an experience. Not one I'd like to relive. Probably because every night the ship moved, I was sure the Titanic was happening again. I would call the officers on the bridge who steer the ship, and they would make bets on what time and how many times I would call in the middle of the night to see if we were gonna make it. And if you're a cruise ship goer, you probably know that you're only supposed to call the bridge if it's a dire emergency, like someone's dying. I'm not proud of it. But I was planning on going back to Colorado to continue performing once my contract was over, but I had an itch I needed to scratch. Start spreading the news, I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York, these vagabond shoes are longing to stray right through the very heart of it. New York, New York, I wanna wake up in a city that doesn't sleep to find I'm king of the hill, top of the heap. These little town blues are melting away right through the very heart of it. New York, New York, if I can make it there, I'll make it anywhere. It's up to you. New York, New York. New York, New York. To find I'm king of the hill, head of the list, cream of the crop at the top of the heap. My little town blues are melting away.
away that I think that I grew from my time on that cruise ship was that I really learned what it was like to be truly alone. Not just relationship-wise, but I literally couldn't communicate with anyone in my life for long stretches of time. I watched a lot of sunrises and sunsets by myself and explored many new worlds on my own, and I really learned what it was like to be my own best friend, to feel as though I was enough. And I actually enjoyed my own company. It was then when I felt like I was happy, whole, and healthy with myself. That's when I knew I was ready to find him.
Somebody hold me too close. Somebody hurt me too deep. Somebody sit in my chair and ruin my sleep and make me aware of being alive, being alive. Somebody hurt me too much. Somebody know me too well. Somebody pull me up short and put me through hell and give me support for being alive. Make me alive. Make me alive. Make me confused. Mock me with praise. Let me be used.
Sung by the famous Bernadette Peters, who my dad actually met in a bar a million years ago and hooked up with. Well, that's a real thing. I always say there's a little bit of Bernadette inside me somewhere. Don't worry, Mom, this was way before you. My first night in New York City, when I just moved here, I had my two suitcases from Hawaii with my sundress and my little flip-flops in February. I didn't regret that at all. And I was drinking wine with my girlfriends on the first night here, and they said to me, "Oh my God, you have to go on this dating website called OkCupid. Everyone in New York is on it." I said, "Absolutely not." Three glasses of wine later, I was halfway done creating my profile. 3 weeks later, I met a man who I then thought was the one. And 3 years later, I was thankful to have had the strength and respect for myself to walk away when I knew it wasn't right. And thank God I did, because now I have everything I've ever wanted and more. But after that first night in New York drinking wine with my girlfriends, it was then time to find a job in this big, scary city, and what better than the famous Ellen Stardust Diner? I mean, I got to sing all day and make lots of dollars, so what could be better than that? It's the 12th time I've sang this song today. Snow glows white on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like a swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried.
Don't tell me not to live, just sit and putter. Life's candy and the sun's a ball of butter. Don't bring around a clown to rain on my parade.
$100 for a 10-hour shift. Almost done now. Home past 4 and tomorrow's audition looks fun now. Waiting, it's steady. This job's pulling me through the lean time. Not quite the dream, but having some fun in the meantime. Pulling in on a table of drunk business guys, cash in their pockets and lust in their eyes. They had a good night, they bought me a shot, didn't remind me of all I have not yet accomplished. I'm waiting, making rent and some friends, waiting, living my life, enjoying the ride, putting ambition a bit to the side, in a job I guess I should be hating, and I'm not, and I'm waiting. She knows now, saying she'll hit that audition, but she never goes now. Philippe at the bar, his girlfriend's expecting about now. He's upping his shifts, knows he'll never get out now. And they all laugh it up and have a good time, from the host to the waiter to bartender Klein, and think they're in luck. How long till you're stuck, always waiting, till the means are the end, waiting on that Midwestern lady who just loves that showbiz. Her daughter takes singing, so she knows how it is, and tips 8%, cause she's not concentrating, waiting. Who said, hey, are those real? Take a stance, make a choice, and I'll shout, I'm a star with what's left of my voice. Chasing your dreams here. Have you been in Cats? I smile as I stifle my screams here. Waiting. Please give a round of applause for Derek Gregor. Derek actually wrote this song with his partner, Sam Carner, who I think is over there. You might know them as the duo Carner and Gregor, who I have had the pleasure of working with multiple times here in New York. I would also like to thank my dear friend Jason Vaughn out in Colorado for putting together that crazy medley. And please welcome back and give a round of applause for Evan Zavada on the panel. The best part about working at Ellen's was that I was able to put myself out there every single day when I walked into work. The most important thing that you can do in this business is make yourself seen and make yourself heard as much as humanly possible. You have got to be ballsy or nothing is ever going to happen for you. No one's going to call you when you're sitting in your bed eating a tub of Ben and Jerry's watching Netflix and offer you a job. This doesn't work that way. But I cannot even tell you how many times someone would walk into Ellen's and then the next day I'm on a flight somewhere to perform. My favorite story like that has got to be when I was singing at this restaurant that I sang at every week, which actually is Joe Manji's restaurant, who's here tonight. Hi! Yay! And this big group of 35 Italian people came in for dinner. So I ended my set with an Italian opera piece, and this man stood up at the end and said, "We bring it to Sicily to sing in the piazza." And I said, "Okay, call me." That man happened to be the mayor of a town in Sicily, and 1 week later at 8 a.m., I get a phone call saying I am being flown out there for 2 weeks to stay on the beach to sing for one night in the piazza for 7,000 people. That actually happened. I remember standing on that stage singing Ave Maria, and the words were coming out of my mouth, but all I could think of was, I might actually be dreaming. I wasn't. This next song is the song I closed with that night, a moment I will never forget. It's called Nessun Dorma, which means none shall sleep.
Nessun dorma, nessun dorma. Tu pioro principe.
Great things were happening for me in my life and my career, and my biggest fan never got to know of them. It would have been a dream that I got to sing in Sicily, and she died days before I found out that I got my first professional job. And that job, almost heaven, I'll never forget when I first got my music and I was driving in my car, belting country roads at the top of my lungs with the biggest smile on my face and the most intense feeling of happiness. And like a light switch, I broke into tears and I started to think about how she really was never gonna be there anymore. To answer the phone when I wanted to tell her about a cute boy I just met, to drink wine with and talk about silly things, to be a part of my future children's lives, and to meet the man I might marry one day. That one really kills me, but a wise woman once told me, if he truly knows and loves you, he truly knows and loves her, because she's such a big part of you. How could he not? This next song was our song, a song I attempted to sing at her funeral, but barely got a word out through my tears. Thought I'd give it another try. For all those times you stood by me, for all the truth that you made me see, for all the joy you brought to my life, for all the wrong that you made right, for every dream you made come true, for all the love I found in you, I'll be forever thankful. You're the one who held me up, never let me fall. You're the one who saw me through it all. You were my strength when I was weak. You were my voice when I couldn't speak. You were my eyes when I couldn't see. You saw the best there was in me, lifted me up when I couldn't reach. You gave me faith 'cause you believed. I'm everything I am because you love me. You gave me wings and made me fly. You touched my hand, I could touch the sky. I lost my faith, you gave it back to me. You said no star was out of reach. You stood by me and I stood tall. I had your love, I had it all. I'm grateful for each day you gave me. Maybe I don't know is true. I was blessed because I was loved by you. You were my strength when I was weak. You were my voice when I couldn't speak. You were my eyes when I couldn't see. You saw the best there was in me, lifted me up when I couldn't reach. You gave me faith 'cause you believed. I'm everything I am because you love me. You were always there for me, the tender wind that carried me, a light in the dark, shining your love into my life. You've been through the lies, you were the truth. My world is a better place because of you. You were my eyes when I couldn't see. You saw the best there was in me, lifted me up when I couldn't reach. You gave me faith because you believed. I'm everything I am because you love me. I'm everything I am because you love me. Have you ever had one of those life-defining moments that completely changed you forever? Mine was my senior year of high school when we got chosen to go to State Thespian Festival with Les Miserables. I was playing Fantine, and I got to sing I Dreamed a Dream on a stage that had 2,610 people. Woo! I will never forget the roar from that audience. And after I finished singing the song, I stumbled off the stage, fell into a chair, barely able to breathe, and thought to myself, I have to do this forever. Every time I sing this song, I hear those 2,610 people, and I remember that feeling, the feeling that I have to sing forever. Doing theater since I was 6 years old, and it was always expected of me that I would move to New York and be on Broadway. And although I always knew that wasn't my real dream, I guess I just pretended it was to, like, live up to everyone else's expectations. But then you grow up and you realize that everyone else's opinions and expectations do not matter. What matters is that you are proud of yourself. Deep down, I always knew what my real dream was. To have a family. To have a normal life with the SUV and the damn white picket fence. And to teach children who have the same love and passion as I do. When I was a kid, I was diagnosed with Tourette syndrome. It wasn't like they make it seem on TV, but it was definitely enough to where it was very noticeable. I will never forget this moment in my sixth grade math class where my teacher looked at me and heard one of those little noises I would make and said in front of the whole class, "Danielle, why are you making that noise?" I didn't want to go to school. I didn't want to be seen. I didn't want to be heard. Theater made me feel safe. Theater made me feel like I wasn't scared to be seen or heard. My tics could be at their worst, but the second I would walk onto that stage, they would disappear completely. I want to make kids feel safe. I want to make kids feel seen and heard. I want to show them that you can love what you do and do what you love in this life. And that's what my high school drama teacher did for me. And I always said I wanted to be just like her. And it really helped to have two parents who were completely supportive and trusted every decision I have made on this crazy journey. So thank you, Mom and Dad. Now I would like to call up one of my students, Daniella Gerbasi, to sing this next song with me. Daniella represents every single one of my students who have sincerely changed me for good.
To those who help us most grow, if we let them and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes the sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the world. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, I have been changed for good. So much of me is made of what I've learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart. And now, whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship alone from its mooring by a wind, like a sea drawn by a sky bird in a distant world. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you,
because I knew you, I have been changed for good.
And
things I've done you blame me for.
But then I guess we know there's blame to share,
and none of it seems to matter anymore.
As a 28-year-old woman, I do not have all the answers. But in my short time on Earth thus far, I have traveled the world doing what I love. I have loved and lost. I have been through heavy physical and emotional pain. And I have seen the beauty in people and places I never knew existed. And there is one thing I now know for sure. Success is your own. You own the definition. You own the word. It is yours and only yours. We have one life, a phrase drilled into me by my dear friend from college who's sitting right in front of me. If you don't wake up every single morning ready and excited to do something that makes you feel alive and that you feel is important, then you haven't found success. And it can be anything, whether it's being a doctor or a lawyer or a mailman or being a nanny or a mom or being on Broadway. I found my success, and I'm so grateful for every decision I've made that has brought me to where I am today. I got here because I fell and picked myself back up. I got here because I stopped listening to what everyone else felt like saying. I got here because I was brave. And if there's one thing I want my students to always remember, be brave, and you will find your success. Oxford Dictionary's definition of success is the accomplishment of an aim or purpose. Webster's Dictionary's definition of success is the attainment of wealth or favor. What's yours? You can be amazing, you can turn a phrase into a weapon or a drug. You can be the outcast or be the backlash of somebody's lack of love. Or you can start speaking up. Nothing's gonna hurt you the way that words do when they settle beneath your skin. Kept on the inside and no sunlight, sometimes a shadow wins. But I wonder what would happen if you say what you want to say and let the words fall out. Honestly, I want to see you be brave with what you want to say and let the words fall out. Everybody's been there, everybody's been staring. stared down by the enemy. Fallen for the fear, intense and disappearing. Bow down to the mighty. Don't run. Stop holding your tongue. Maybe there's a way out of the cage where you live. Maybe one of these days you can let the light in. Show me how big your brain is. Say what you wanna say and let the words fall out. Honestly, I wanna see you be brave with what you wanna say and let the words fall out. Honestly, I wanna see you be brave. In a sense, your history of silence won't do you any good. Did you think it would? Let your words be anything but empty. Why don't you tell